up, African family? I am Dr. Nteri Nelson of the Academy of Kemetic Education and Wellness, where we teach the African origins of the ancient wisdom. I am a metaphysician, an educator, and a clinician, and co-founder of the Academy, and I'm also adjunct faculty at the University of Massachusetts in Boston. This presentation is entitled Kemetic Karest-mas Celebration. Not to be confused anymore with Christmas celebration. Like Kwanzaa demonstrates an African celebration, this research demonstrates the practice of a kemetically conscious Karest-mas celebration by our African ancestors of the Nile Valley Kemet, later called Egypt. This research is based on the wisdom of our ancestors as recorded in the pyramid texts, the Pertemru, the Metcher language, and the books that I have authored, Ka'aba, Building Lighted Temple, with keys to the Tree of Life, and Ka'aba, the Great Pyramid, is the Tree of Life, Merkaba. When we look at the title, Kemetic Karest-mas, we are at first brought to the Metcher terms, Ka, given to us by our African ancestors. And for our African ancestors, they teach us that Ka means spirit, that all is spirit, and that Ka, spirit, takes up the substance of itself to see itself in form, to manifest. Rest is how we arise, how we move in a cycle of birth and rebirth, from the tomb to the womb to be born again. Mes is birth. So it is the birth of an ever-living and eternal spirit that is taking place within us. Just as cosmically our sun in the sky, S-U-N, undergoes a seeming death at the winter solstice only to be resurrected again, so too does man and woman as son, S-O-N, and daughter enact a seeming death and rebirth or resurrection as a Karest, the ever-coming one, the spirit that does not die but is reborn. We are the Karest. In this reconstruction of a Karest-mas celebration, we will move step by step to re-spiritualize those elements of our traditional African spirituality that have been materialized, perverted, Europeanized, debased, renamed, and potentized to injure the African consciousness. We at first will pull back the veil that has been thrown upon our African spirituality, and we reclaim our sacred symbols once the distortions are removed and their meaning is ungobbled. We at first come in our symbol to incorporate in a Kemetic Karest celebration, we come to our divine trinity and reclaim the divine trinity of Osir and Osset and Haru, later called Osiris, Isis, and Horus by the Greeks. This is our celestial and our terrestrial African family that predates Christianity. This trinity and its divine qualities are within us. Next, we reclaim the symbol of our mother, our African Madonna and child, as Osset in Haru, and Haru is the Karest. Later, these symbols take on a different appearance and are named Mary, Jesus, and the Christ. We reclaim the Osir, who was Neb, Lord of the World, and we'll see here that the symbols of Osir would later be Christianized as the Pope, and all his symbols of power would be Christianized. Next, we continue with the sacred symbols and language of Medjunetje. These are key terms, Ka'aba, for building the lighted temple, the monument which is us. The pyramid texts, the Pertemru, the Medjunetje teach us that our African ancestors were masters in the science of the soul, the journey of the soul, and the spiritual anatomy or constitution, which is both human and divine. We come to the term Ab. After we finish with the term Ka, we come to the term Ab. And Ab, for the Kemetians, symbolizes the human heart. Ab is the seat of conscience and growing soul consciousness. This is where we locate the Haru, or the Karest within us, in the heart. And Bar means soul. So as we become fully conscious of the relationship between spirit and matter, Haru within us becomes the fully conscious Ba soul or Osir in his or her journey. Haru becomes as Osir. This is later Christianized by, reframed by Christianity as my father and I are one. Next, we see that Ka'aba correspond with the divine trinity of Oset, Haru, and Osir. These are the three aspects of divinity in the tree of life shown next. And we can see here in the tree of life, Ka, spirit, corresponds with Oset, mother, spirit matter. Ab corresponds with Haru, son, daughter. And Ba corresponds with Osir, Ba, father, soul, spirit. Next, we want to reclaim the symbol of Ma'at and the 42 laws of Ma'at: truth, justice, righteousness, order, balance, harmony, reciprocity, which teach us how to live in accord with the laws of nature. But our corpus of law would later be reduced to the Ten Commandments by Christianity. Next, we want to reclaim the judgment scene in which the weighing of the heart is occurring. This is very key to our Karest-mas celebration. It is here, as we stand as Haru, that the purifying fires of our heart have done the work of transmuting, of changing all the heavy matters of life that we have faced, like anger, jealousy, cruelty, self-pity, bitterness, and so on. All of these that make the heart heavy like lead against the lightness of the feather on the scale of my heart. We see the weighing of the heart, which is held in balance against the lightness of the feather of my heart. So in this next slide, as we come before the Neb, Lord of the world, or Sir, we want our heart to be as light as the feather of my heart. Led by Haru, which is within us, we have become light-filled in a presence that can now stand before the awesome presence, who Osir, who is within the shrine, Osir, who is Neb, Lord of the world. So we become the presence that stands before the awesome presence. We are found innocent in Makaru, a truer voice, not to be confused with presents or packages at Christmas time brought by Santa Claus. And I'm going to talk more about this in a moment after we see how this concept has been distorted. Next, we reclaim the symbol of Osir, who was slain by his jealous brother Set. And we reclaim the symbol of the evergreen tree of beautiful scent, of beautiful fragrance, called the tamarisk tree, which grew around the sarcophagus or the coffin in which Osir rested once it had drifted along the Nile to Byblos. This is very significant in our reacquisition of a Kemetic Karest-mas celebration. The tree of life is a divine template for building the lighted temple. And in my book long ago, I dispel the word tamarisk to reveal the word Christmas. Almost spelled backwards, we see that when we ungarble our symbols, we can come to see and understand rightly. Next, in this symbol, we have the seven planes of consciousness or soul bodies symbolized by the tree of life given to us by the ancient texts. And by detailing these, which they name Ba, Ku, Shechem, Ab, Sahu, Ka, Kabit, Kat, our ancestors have given us the blueprint for constructing our temple. By reconnecting with our Kemetic science, we see the way to build our own monumental temple symbolized by the Karest-mas tree. Next, we reclaim the Pot Neteru, the company of the gods, who imbue us with qualities of divinity in our journey. So here on the left, we see the tree of life laid out in a straight line or linearly, and we see all the nature, the deity, like Tehuti, who give us divine intelligence, like Herakuti, who give us strength, like Ma'at, law and morality, and so on, and I write more about this in my book. In this next symbol on the right, we see the macabre pictured, and here is how we move deeper into our monument construction. So hold on to your seats. We're moving deeper into our construction here. The macabre is pictured here as the double pyramid, one above and one below, and the square in between. The tree of life is the great pyramid, macabre. Now, how does the tree of life become the macabre? We are not crucified upon the tree. Rather, in our journey, we are the tree of life that now bends over backwards upon itself, like the nude posture pictured here, like the Sankofa symbol pictured here, like the serpent swallowing its tail. As Heru, we are bending over backwards. We are knitting, and as we do so, we are knitting ourselves back together again. We are uniting the seeming dualities of Ka and Ba, spirit and matter, mother and father, Osir and Oset, masculine and feminine, and the North and South Poles within our constitution, which is both human and divine. As Heru, we are completing our circuitry to become energy bodies of light, the macabre body of light. And if you've ever had to get your battery charged, you know you have to complete that circuitry in order to have the energy and the power. We move from a linear identity symbolized by the tree of life to a spherical identity symbolized by the macabre energy body of light, where we are rounding and smoothing out the edges in our constitution, in our character, building to become a more perfect sphere like the sun. The tree of life is the great pyramid, the macabre. And we see here the rise, in the next slide, this rising, this resurrection of the sun daughter is the bending back of the tree of life, where the radiant heart of Heru, the sun, comes to the apex of the great pyramid of Giza, also called the Merkutu, as indicated by the arrow here. This rising is the resurrection of the sun daughter, which we call Heru the Karest. This is the crowning and seating of Heru upon his or her throne as sun daughter. You are the Karest, a divine presence on earth. But in this next slide, we see as we knit ourselves back together again, we undergo the uniting of the North and South within our own spiritual anatomy. We reclaim the symbol of the red and white crown worn by Nesubiti of Nama. He united, and who was ruler of Kemet around 3100 BCE. He united the North and South of Kemet and was the first man recorded wearing the crown of unification. So as Heru, we undergo the seating as king upon our throne, as heir of Osir and Oset and to the kingdom. But the Kemetic white and red crown of Kemet becomes distorted into the Santa Claus hat of Christmas. And here we see Pope Benedict XVI appearing at the Vatican wearing a Santa-style hat known as the Kamaru. Next, we reclaim our sacred symbol of the crook of Osir, which would become the candy cane of Christmas. The crook is the symbol of how we carry our load and are aided to walk the narrow middle path of initiation. It is no coincidence that we are attracted to Christmas and Christianity because it is derived from out of our African divinity and wisdom. And in my work, I have been relentless in dispelling the symbols that take us back to the root source and truth before it was co-opted. Next, we must reclaim the symbol of the Djet and Tet pillar. This is the symbol of stability, the backbone of Osir. And here we see the raising up of the Djet Tet pillar, causing it to stand, which was a celebration in Kemet. And this is key to our Karest-mas celebration today. The tamarisk tree, the erica tree, the evergreen tree, the Christmas tree all correspond with the Dejet pillar. You can see the correspondence here between the Dejet pillar and the tamarisk tree, which I write more about in my books. Now raised and caused to stand, the tamarisk tree is then adorned by the light of the Netaru spheres, divine energies we call upon. So we adorn the tamarisk tree with spheres of the Netaru. Next, let us reclaim the symbol of the sacred boat on its sledge. But the sledge would become the sleigh of Christmas. Pictured at left is the Ark of the God Sukkur on its sledge. But when we dispel this symbol, we see what would later become the sleigh. Notice the antlers on the left and the antlers on the right. The sledge on the left bears the divine presence of nature, of deity. The sleigh on the right bears Santa Claus with Christmas presents and packages. This sacred boat has profound meaning in our African spirituality as glimpsed in the following passage from the Pertimru. On the great day of the festival of Sukkur, which was celebrated in many places throughout Kemet, the ceremony of placing the Sukkur boat upon its sledge was performed at sunrise under the direction of the high priest of Menefer. This official was expected to lift the Sukkur boat upon its sledge and to march at the head of the process, which drew the loaded sledge round the sanctuary. By this action, the revolution of the sun and other celestial bodies was symbolized. So, finally, let us claim our symbol as we stand before the awesome presence, the Neb Lord of the world. How may we regain understanding and application of ancient wisdom in our modern daily practices so that we may overcome this materialistic consciousness now gripping our earth and associated with Christmas? Do you want more packages and presents under the Christmas tree, or do you want to be the presence we seek as we come before the awesome presence, Neb, Lord of the world, or Sur? In our Karest-mas celebration, let us pour libation to our ancestors. Facing east, let us recite the hymn to Haru. Facing west, let us be in recitation of the 42 laws of Ma'at. Facing south, let us raise up the Dejet pillar as symbolized by the tamarisk tree, tree of stability, upon which is the backbone of Sur, upon which the sun rises. Let us adorn the evergreen tamarisk tree with a sphere of light, with the spheres for each Netaru lighting the tree. Let us, facing north, recite the qualities of each one. Let each family member come forth and say which law of my art they are working with, which Netaru qualities of divinity they are working to cultivate more of, to have a greater presence, a Surian-like presence, standing before the Neb, Lord of the world, to be of greater benefit and service on earth. And then let us sing reascension into sacredness, and then let us feast. Through these steps, we undergo a spiritual reconstruction. Through these steps, we understand a truer meaning of the resurrection of the sun, sun-daughter, which we call Haru, the Karest, in our practice of a Kemetic Karest-mas celebration. Du'a'u, du'a'u, netanetaru. Thank you.